बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स, होप यू ऑल आर डूइंग गुड। यू नो दिस इज न्यू ऑक्सफोर्ड मॉडर्न इंग्लिश बुक ऑफ ग्रेड 7 एंड दिस इज यूनिट नंबर 1 पार्ट बी। नो यू ऑल हैव टू ओपन योर टेक्स्ट बुक्स ऑफ इंग्लिश एंड टुडे वी विल डू द रीडिंग of this unit and the exercise. This is the poem. No hair stands for November. So in this poem describes the scene of November, the month of November.
Yeah.
November by Thomas Wood is the name of the poet who has written this poem. So in this poem he has described about the month of November. Then what happens when there is fog and snow everywhere? These are the difficult words. Courtesy, respectful or considerate act. And then, inkling, indication. The other side, the way. The other side of the road. More, morning. Steeple, a tall tower. Locomotion, ability to move. Gentility, believe, vague idea, locomotion, ability to move. Gentility, gentleness, notion, believe or vague idea. So now come towards the exercise. These are the question answers of this unit. The first question is, in what way is the title of the poem a good one? The title is good one because it is reflected in every line of poem, including the last line, in which the poem is summarized by yet and other no word, November. Here you can see the whole poem is based on November, and the last line, in last line, poet has used again the word November. He has summarized his poem and he used no for November. Is there a rhyme scheme to the poem? There is no regular rhyming pattern. Some of the lines are rhyming couplets, but this is not constant. So no regular rhyming scheme. Which words in the poem tell us about the following? First, triumphs of day. Poem में कौन-कौन से words हैं जो हमें बताते हैं? Morn, noon, dawn, dusk, afternoon. Roads, road, street, the other side the way, row, rain. Motion or interaction, recognition, perceive, showing, knowing. Traveling, notion, go, inkling. Weather condition or geographical features. Sun, moon, sky, earthly view, land, ocean, coast, park. So these words describe weather condition or geographical features. Living creatures and plants, people, company, nobility, member, butterflies, bees, fruits, flowers, birds. D. How would you describe the general picture painted by the poet? Is it a cheerful one? The poem describes a month, November, in which there are a lot of negatives indicated by no. The poet described this season as being one without warmth or cheerfulness. However, he does this in a cheerful way. So the poem is not depressing or sad. The poet has described the number in a cheerful way. E. Do you think the poet has a good sense of humor? Why? Although the poem is full of negative statements, the poet still manages to make it sound fairly cheerful. The rhyming couplets, the use of the same word, start each line, and the pace at which the poem moves all help to make it cheerful. Question number 2. Answer the following with reference to context. A. What is meant by the other side, the way? Answer is, it literally means the other side of the road. B. Why do you think the phrase no go is put in inverted commas while others, for example, no mail are not? No go is in inverted commas because it is what was said by the transport authorities. So that's why it is written in the inverted commas. C. What does the rim refers to? The rim is the circular course in Hyde Park in London. Hyde Park is in London, used for riding and driving. Comment on the phrase no afternoon generally. Generally refers to people who are courteous and well-mannered when out walking. Such people would greet each other. This is not evident in this drawing because it is November and very cold. So nobody is out walking and greeting or talking to each other. These were the questions. Next topic is the summary of this unit. No summary. In this poem, November, the poet Thomas Wood describes the bleakness of a November. Bleakness, desolateness, sunsani, udasi, virani. A heavy fog obscures everything. The sun, the moon, the steeples, the woodways, the parks, even the faces of people on the streets. Travel closed down because of the fog is observed. There are no mail deliveries and no ships arriving with news from foreign countries. Autumn has stripped the leaves from the trees, killed the flowers and fruits, and banished birds, bees, and butterflies. There is nothing left to cheer those wandering through the city. Find words in the poem which may be described in the following ways. A. The star in the center of the solar system, which are described in the poem. Sun. The Earth's only natural satellite. Moon. Appropriate or correct? Proper. The first appearance of light in the sky as the sun rises at the beginning. Dawn. Signs are signals, indications. Well known, commonly seen or heard, easily recognized, familiar. The perception that somebody has been seen before and is knowing, recognition. A vague idea or suspicion about a fact, person or event, inkling. Contented and relaxed. Comfortable. Limb, member. An insect of the order Lepidoptera, butterfly. Heat, affection, friendliness, warmth. The next question is underline the pronouns and say whether they are used as subjects or objects and whether they are singular or plural. You know what is the pronoun which comes in the place of the noun. Noun ki jagah jo istemal kiya jata hai. Direct noun ko nahi istemal kiya jata. So we use pronoun there. He selected the workers. He singular. Ek shakhs ki baat ho rahi hai. So he singular and he is the subject. They wanted to help the villagers. They plural and subject. So plural subject. Asif said he would give them some wood. He, singular pronoun, them, plural, object, singular subject, he, and them is the plural object. David's sister came with us, us, plural object. She asked Ahmed to contact me, she, singular, she, subject, me, singular, object. I have never met the Prime Minister. I, singular, subject, to whom I never met, singular, object. Do you know him? You, singular, subject, him, singular, object. I wonder where she has put the basket. I, singular subject, she, singular object. It was under the chair a minute ago. It, singular subject. Students, you have to write this book work on your notebooks, and you have to write the question answers and exercise of this unit on your notebooks, and you have to prepare them. Come towards our grammar part. The grammar work which we are going to do today is about simple present tense. What is simple present tense? It tells about an action that happens now, or it tells or shows habitual action. Action that happens now, they take place now. Habitual action, action which we do on daily basis, like I get up early in the morning, I go to school daily, he daily goes for a walk. These are habitual action. Formation. Positive sentences, subject plus first form of verb plus object. Remember, S or ES is used with the main verb when there is third person. That is, he, she, it, singular. When there is third person singular, we will use S or ES. For example, he reads a book. She watches TV at 9 p.m. I get up early in the morning. When there is third person singular, we use S and ES. This is first person I, so we don't use S or ES. First person I will, second person you, your, third person he, she, it, they, plural. I play cricket, you play cricket, he plays cricket. So we use S with the third person singular he. How to make negative sentences using the present tense? Subject plus do not or does not, first form of verb plus object. I, we, you, they. We will use do not with third person singular, he, she, it, we will use does not. He does not read a book. She does not watch TV at 9 p.m. Now we will never use watches because we have used does, so here we will never use as a ES. Because first form of verb we applied here. I do not get up early in the morning. Remember, do will come with the first person, I, we, second person, you, and third person, plural. Interrogative sentences. In interrogative sentences, the helping verb do and does will come at the start of the sentences. Do, does, subject, plus first form of verb, plus object. Does he read a book? Does She watched TV at 9 p.m. Do I get up early in the morning? And question mark is used at the end of the interrogative sentences. First form of verb is used in simple present tense, and SRES are used in negative sentences. We use helping verb do not and does not, and interrogative sentences do and does will come at the start of the sentence. Now, how to make or how to change the sentence from active form to passive voice? When the active verb is in simple present tense, we make passive verbs form with is, am, are plus past participle form of the verb, and object of active verb becomes the subject of passive verb. You have to remember this thing, that object of active verb, when we change that into passive voice, so object will become the subject of passive verb. And we will use third form of verb with is, am, are, that is past participle. However, in most cases, the object is not mentioned in the passive voice. She writes a story. She, subject, writes, verb, story, object. A story becomes the subject. Object will change into the subject. A story is write, third form of verb, verb, past participle, written by her. So we have changed this active verb into passive voice. She adores kids. So kids here are objects, and when we change this into passive voice, kids become the subject. Kids are adored by her, and subject will change into object, and object will change into subject. He helps us. We are helped by him. Doctors treat patients. Patients are treated by doctor. These were the rules how to change the active verb into the passive form. And there are some examples of simple present tense. The first one is the train leaves every morning at 8 a.m. When we convert this into negative, the train does not leave. So we have used the first form of verb here, leave every morning at 8 a.m. When does the train usually leave? Interrogative sentence. She always forgets her purse. She does not always forget her purse. Does she always forget her purse? You have to make the write the examples of simple present tense, at least 5 examples, and you have to change them into negative and interrogative sentences on your notebook. This was our today's lecture. Hope you will learn that. Thank you. Allah.